It's gonna take longer.
Okay, at this time, I will close the closed session, and we are now back in session. At this time, I would like to introduce you to our new county manager. If Mr. Honeycutt will stand up, this is Craig Honeycutt, and he will be coming with us in April, first of April, and April the 6th, and we look forward to working with you. And if anybody's got any questions tonight, just follow him out and.
Following back to Laurinburg.
Mr. Boyer has already.
Bob said how much money?
Well, did we discuss that money?
It was a ton, whatever.
I know, we didn't mention it in there, actually. We were talking about that. I guess I can tell that. Well, his salary will be $112,000, and he will have a $3,000 allowance for his automobile, and he will also have travel money, at whatever the current rate, which is 55 cents a month. So, and I think that's about all at this point. Okay?
Madam Chairman, is there to be any sort of contract formally?
Yes.
And was that also decided on?
Yes.
And when will that document be available?
I do not know if it will be available at this point. I guess it's a public record, but I don't know. When will that be available?
Clyde's got it.
Well, Clyde has got
it. We've signed it.
Huh?
Everybody has to sign it.
Okay.
Yeah. And he signed it.
No, it's not an annual contract. It's just a contract with the county.
Okay, so it's open
air. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we told him we had a fire squad. Well, I'm just kidding. So he'll be glad to speak with anybody, and please introduce yourself to him, and so we can make him welcome. And we also thank Tim for working with us on this. He's got some things lined up, and he's going to, he's fixed him a little packet. And anything we can do for you, you let me know. Other than I can't sell your house.
Yes, ma'am.
And neither can Eddie. So.
That's right.
At this time, I'll ask the commissioners, do you have any comments? Tim? Ann?
I have just one. I think you had in your package a letter from
Harry Aldridge.
Representative Aldridge, and I think all of you probably got one at home also, where he had introduced a bill to disapprove the Jordan Lake rules. And then also he's requesting of the board members individually and also collectively, I would think, just wanting to know our views in terms of should I compromise or should I continue on in opposing. And I would just like to respectfully get a consensus and us send a letter as this board, governing board, telling Mr. Aldridge that we oppose the Jordan Lake rules. Just we hadn't changed in our beliefs, and we continue to oppose it. And I'd just like for staff to do that. I'd just like a consensus of the board. That's okay to do that.
I called his Raleigh office, and he was busy. I left the same message, basically, individually.
Yeah.
Well, I wrote him and responded and told him that I did not believe in this situation there should be a compromise.
Okay. So we may not have a consensus then, eh?
I think we're opposing the rules as they're written.
Okay.
That's what we're saying.
Exactly.
And I think that's basically what he said.
Yeah, just a letter that we oppose the rules as they're written.
I actually talked with Ronnie Wall this week at the Council on Government meeting that I was at, and he had been in Raleigh that day, actually. And there is some, I do not know what it is, but he says that whatever it is, it's not going to cost them as much as they thought it was, but I don't know any details on that. So maybe you guys ought to call Ronnie.
Madam Chair, we are working with Burlington, Durham, Rockingham, Guilford, Greensboro to put together an alternative that eliminates some of the more onerous rules.
Yeah, I think the existing development rules are probably the
what we'd like to do, once that draft bill is finalized, bring it to you and let you look at it.
Okay.
I think it's a lot more palatable than what we have.
Yeah, Ronnie told me that there was a lot more to do.
And we'll ask the press for their assistance at the appropriate time.
Have you read Senator Farris's bill that he's put in?
I have not read it. I know he filed it last week.
And we thank him for his endeavors, and our staff is in the process of working together with the other municipalities in the county, and if he would just stay in close contact with us, we will with him. How does that sound? Okay.
Okay. Any more comments?
Did we come to a conclusion on what we will do about the robbers and what's going on as far as taxes are concerned?
They have to appeal their taxes. They're not assessed as yet. What I'm understanding? I tried to find some assessments. I see zeros on there. I don't know. I don't think there's been any assessment. Is that right? Are you with that understanding?
That's my understanding is they have not billed them yet. Isn't that correct, Clyde? They haven't billed them yet.
So right.
There's just been some assumptions made, maybe, and some rumors going around, I guess, and so the billing process hasn't taken place yet.
Basically, what
Kim was asking is to let it go through its exhaust all of their appeals first, and then at that point, the ones that still want to come before y'all, but they would then have an opportunity to come before y'all to see if you would, on an individual basis, make any exceptions to what the position of the tax department is doing. That's kind of what she was asking.
So they have not been assessed. Well, they've kind of been assessed, but they have not been billed, okay?
Right.
So, they've been audited, and the assessment value is on their audit, but they have not been sent the bills yet.
Okay, this law comes down from Raleigh, is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, is there a possibility we can get a copy of that? Well, I'm sure
It's in the Machinery Act. I have a copy. It's a like a copy of the New Testament.
Can you condense it in plain English?
It's almost as confusing as the Book of Revelation.
That's plain English? Is it plain English?
I think if we let it go through its normal course, the assessor take a look at it, our Board of Equalization, which is appointed by you folks, and that's why they're there.
Yeah.
The folks in Raleigh know that tax laws are the most confusing thing they've ever come up with. And then once the Board of Equalization looks at it, if it's still not satisfied, then they can take it to Raleigh.
Yeah.
And from there, they go to the Court of Appeals if they're not happy.
Because my main concern is a small business, as well as the farmers all grouped together.
It may very well be addressed by our Board of Equalization, and I have to go with folks.
Okay. You're good with that?
Yes.
Are there any announcements?
Well, Madam Chair, I'd like to mention one thing about the planning board, that Jason had his planning board meeting last week, and kind of bring everybody up to date. And if you go online, he has got that posted with the suggested changes. So for the rest of the commissioners, if you want to look at that, have any input to it. And it's also got a list of our planning board members now, so everybody can contact their representative.
I was here, but I didn't. We had a good planning board meeting.
And the next one is next Tuesday, I think.
We'll call a special meeting for next Tuesday at 7 here in the Commissioner's Room.
Any more announcements? If not, our meeting is adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham.